Hello and welcome to another Nikomedia tutorial. A few days ago, a follower sent me this picture and asked me if we can do this in Cinema 4D2. And he tried it with sculpting and something else, but yeah, so I think yes, we can do this in Cinema 4D2. And yeah, this is from Krytomir Just, or Just, I don't know. Sorry if I speak it wrong and what I'm sure do. Yeah, and he has some very nice pictures. So he have this Gold Rush series here. That's some very nice ideas. I like it. So yeah, but we go to this picture here, and yeah, let's try this. I haven't tried it before now, but I think I have an idea how it works, how it could work. So let's go to Cinema. I have this picture on the side here, so I can see what I do. And yeah, I start with this coffee cup. I think we have one coffee cup in the content browser, as far as I know. And let's go and make it shift F8, so yeah, more space. It was on the broadcast, I think, 3D objects, dinnerware. And here we have a cup, yep. Okay, I drag this out here, and we have a nice cup here. Good. I just need the cup, so I don't need this lathe here. Good, deactivate this. Next thing I do is I select this lathe here, go in the edge mode, and I select a loop selection UL for loop selection, and select where I want to start this gold coffee thing, so where it starts this surface. So I think I'll do it somewhere like here or here. Okay. And now I say edge to spline. I have it here in my toolbar. If I don't have any toolbar, it's somewhere on the mesh commands. And edge to spline. You will find everything I have here. You will find it somewhere. I stop now to say you can find it here. You can find it here. You can find it here. If you don't find it, just hit Shift C on your keyboard, and you can give here edge to spline, edge to spline, and you see it. And you double click it, and you have it too. So if you don't find any tool, just Shift C and searches with the command line. So, okay, edge to spline, and I have here a spline now. What I want to make is, I want to make an loft nerves for this wave thing here. So I go to my slate spline here. First, what I want to do is center the axis. So I go to my spline, and with magic center somewhere here, you can send, I make it with my magic center here. Center the axis of the spline. You can make it with the axis center tool here too. And yeah, and now I go in the side view somewhere. But I want the left camera here, so. Okay. And now I take this spline and I control drag it. So with control drag, I make a copy of the spline. But first I want the spline, I want the axis, not exactly in the middle. I want it here on the Z axis, here on the right side, so I can scale it later from this point, for this position here. And for this, I go to the axis center tool here and go in the Z axis and on the right here. It's the wrong, I'm going to here, okay. And I have my axis where I want it. And now with I control drag this spline up. Somewhere like here, and T for scale, and now I scale it down, so like this. And I do this again with E, control drag it up, make it a little smaller, T for scale, and I scale it again a little bit. E, control drag it up, somewhere like here, T for scale, and scale it again. Something like that, E, control drag it, And control drag again, so something like that. Now we have these things here. And now I make a loft NURBS. A loft here. And put this all the splines, so the spline here and there, all the splines in the loft here. And I get something like that. Looks funny, and it is, so I take this one spline. Now I can refine this a little bit, you see, so something like that. Next one, and refine it here, so however you want it. Something like that. Okay. Okay, and I want this one a little little like this here. And because we have the axis here on the side, on the right side, you see it scales from this point, and so I don't touch this side, I just scale it in this side here. And this looks quite nice. Now we want this wave thing here. Let's try how we can, but I want this loft a little nicer, so I go to my loft. First I say I want an organic form. You see, it looks much better. And I want more subdivisions, because I want to play later on. We want to make this bulges here with this magnet tool, and here I want the more subdivisions. So I say, let's say here 20, no, not isopumps, not isopumps, are here 20, and here about 40, something like that. Okay, the next thing is I want a bend deformer. So, and scale the bend deformer down, it's much too big, you see. So, and put it somewhere like here. And have a look in which direction we bend. I never know this. So, okay, R. So, now this should be okay. Make it a little smaller here. And now I put this loft in an null object, so it's Alt G. Say this is the wave. And put the bend deformer under the null object. So everything what is in this null object then will work with the bend deformer. So, whoops, and you see, it starts to bend. Down here. Then more, of course. So, something like that. Keep the length. Make the bend deformer a little longer here. So, that looks quite nice. Is too broad here, so we can still play with the lathe snap here. So T for scale, scale it down here, and scale this down. And you can shape your thing, your wave, however you want, of course. And now the spline would be here without the deformer. So the next deformer. It here, okay. Maybe make this smaller here and smaller there, so something like this. And the last one, maybe not so broad. So we have later on still possibilities to change the shape, but now and here for the caps, I go in the loft nubs, caps, and say the start cap, like a fillet cap. Whoops, this is a little too big, maybe. 0.05. Yo. maybe 0.1, and I want to constrain it. No, it doesn't have to be constrained. It's okay like this. So, but I want quartz here. Now we have here a nice thing. Okay, and we almost have our wave here. And where is the original file? Let's look. Somewhere. I lost it. Let's go to here. Make this a little smaller here. So. Okay. And this looks good, if you ask me. Okay. Next thing I want to do, I make this editable, this whole loft thing. But before I do this, I make a backup folder, of course, and put my whole loft, or put the whole wave thing inside. So I go to the control, drag it, so make a copy. Okay, we don't have to do this, but so. And here, I go to the loft and say current state to object. So I right click on it and say current state to object. Or you have it here. I have this. Now I can delete my loft. And have it here. Now I select everything. And again, connect objects and delete. We could have done this with the edit optimize script too, but I just forgot now. I don't know why. But so we can do it again as well. So connect objects and delete. So we have one object, and now to be safe, we can optimize again. So optimize wherever you optimize. So now I have everything, and now I put the pen deformer under my loft. And say again current state to object. So now I can delete this one too, and I have just one object here. And now in point mode, MI for the magnet tool, and this is much too big, I think, for the moment. Yeah, it's much too big. So what I do is I press the middle mouse button and drag to the left side so I can make it smaller. Of course, you can put in the radius here too, but. And for the moment, I want just to drag it in the Z axis. So I pick X, no, Y, null, and Z. So when I push it now out, it goes just in the Z axis. Okay, this was not so bad. maybe not so far, but. Make it a little smaller here. Like here a bigger one. So, maybe let's bring it. I'll give it here to 50. 50-50. So I can work it a little bit. Nice. Here you can play. As long as you want, as much as you want. Give it some creamy shape or something else. So, something like this. Okay. Maybe here back, so. Okay, but we can change this later on too. And as I said, we can change now the shape here too. So when I go, can stay in the point mode, there's no problem. And UL for loop selection. And let's say I want it here more narrow, this here, so make this loop selection. And go to scale. And now I can go to the soft selection here and say enable, and now we see nothing because this radius is much too big. So let's go down to 3 centimeters. But now you see where it affects it, and here now you can simply make this a little smaller if you want, so you can affect it still now. But I don't want it like this. So. Like this, maybe so. UL again here, tiefer scale. So. And maybe UL here. Oops, oh, come on. Tiefer scale. Okay, something like this. Maybe here UL, then UF for field selection. And I select this here too. And T for scale again. And here I wanna say maybe 2 centimeter. And scale all a little. Everything a little down here, so okay. And maybe it's UL, maybe here it's a little too narrow, so up a little. Yeah, that's better. Okay. Good, now we have this shape. So of course you can do it much better than that, but just to show you how you can work with this. And in the original file, we have a, this is not straight, this cup here, and this goes a little to the right, this whole thing. So let's do this. Let's go to our loft knobs here, and I take here an FFD deformer. This is this one, so this is loft selected. I hold my shift key, press on the FFT, so it becomes a child of it and has the exact size I want. Here I need just so and go in point mode, null for a rectangle selection and select these points. And what I do is just I drag this to the side here. So and now if I go to my cup, let's bring all in one null, so I'll bring this wave in the coffee cup here, so now we can rotate this and so something like that. Okay. So let's make a square picture. So I want to render with GI. Output 720. Okay. Something like that. Activate the subdivision for the lathe too, so and it looks not bad. But we have in the original file we have some spheres around, so let's make some spheres. For this we take a simple sphere here. Yeah, am I blind? So make it small, 0.5, we have a small scene here. And clone this sphere. MoGraph, Alt click on cloner. So we have clone here and say grid array to 5 by 5 by 5. E, remove the cloner little up. So we have here some spheres. Make the sphere a little smaller. So something like that. On the cloner, and we want the random effector so that we can change the scale a little bit and the positions. So, random effector. With the cloner selected, the random effector, click. And the random effector is then here, where it should be. And yeah, I want position, but maybe 5 centimeter. That's too much. 2 centimeter. That's too less. 3 centimeter. No, 5 centimeter was okay. Yeah, but maybe put something on 10 centimeter even is okay. So, And scale, uniform scale, absolute and point minus 8, I would say, or minus 0.8, so minus 0.8, so it must be so. Now we have here some bubbles. And I want the bubble exactly here to this blob here and here to this blob. So just take this sphere, copy it out, and E, remove tool, go in model mode, and put one about here. So, come on here, so. Okay, and another one, control, drag it down, so I have a copy. Here about so maybe like this. Okay, this a little, I'll make this a little bigger maybe, so and now find a nice angle, so, and we can, we should save this. Should I save it? Yeah, why not? Let's save it to coffee. Okay, now we need, we don't need this material. This is the original material from the content browser. I can put this to here, so. Let's make a material for the cup. This was a something like a red plastic. Yep. So I go to the color channel. Let's see. This red could work. Here is my, this is my default here, but yours will look different, but we need here just a GGX layer. Sorry, or a Backman layer. Then I use GGX, Final, and here I want dielectric and go to bed. And let's say 10 here for the roughness. Put this on the cup. And let's make a gold material. You know, meanwhile, gold material is an easy thing. Just a GGX layer with conductor, and in the custom we go to gold. And here, let's say 10.2, so. And put it on our wave. Come on. Open it first, so. Go to my wave, to the loft here. And to the spheres here, and to the cloner. To the cloner sphere, and to this sphere, and to this sphere. Okay, and now we need something to reflect, because if we render this now, we won't see a lot. We see nothing. Of course, we need something to reflect and to light our scene, you know this. And I, of course, use my scene rig again. You can use a normal light or something else, or a sky with an HDRI on it, but I use my scene rig. And let's see what I get now. I get something like this. Okay, good start. I don't want the floor a little down here. Let's go to the second floor. And bring this up a little bit here too. And a little down with the floor. So I have the shadow here. Yeah, this looks not bad. Then, this is not bad at all. So. I don't want this ambient occlusion here. At least not here for the whole scene. So you will see now that the cup is much brighter. And this is what I want. And here is okay, I have enough shadows here. If I need more, I can bring this back with my rig. But this looks very nice so far. And I want, in other backgrounds, so make, I don't want the gradient here, I just need one color. Oops, and say something like this. Light bluish, something like this. Okay. Nice, but for me that it is not the correct HDRI, I think. Let's bring another HDRI in. I have here, let's see, an HDRI. So we can test the HDRIs here, that's much easier. Indoor HDRI and one of my favorites, of course. Let's see what we get. This is a very nice reflection, indeed. The preview is much too big, so let's try to find a nice spot. Or another HDRI. Let's see what this. Oh, nice. Nice, 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 nice. Yeah, this is a nice shine, I think. Okay, I think I go with this. This looks not bad. Looks very nice. But I want the cup a little brighter. And so, let's try to go up in the rig with the HDRI, light intensity, let's say 150. Yeah, that's it, that's it. That's it. And now let's see how this looks with a better. I think I have enough shadows here. If it's not enough shadow for you, if we don't have really shadow, it's ambient occlusion. I could bring ambient occlusion just for the floor in, so go to my floor, ambient occlusion and activate it. So I have ambient occlusion, you see now it's darker here. I have it just on the floor and not on the cover. But I don't think that I need ambient occlusion at the moment. Let's make a better render, so let's go to high. Why not? 720 by 720. This should render quite fast. So I don't need ambient occlusion, I said. And this is all okay. So far. Yeah, and you will get the project file, so you will have the render settings here too. I can delete the Octane settings. We don't need the Octane settings. So, and let's see how fast this renders, if it renders fast. Okay, so I do it with here with one team render machine too, so it's a little until it sends it to the. Yeah, this renders quite fast. Nice. But I have one problem, we shouldn't see here the thing. Why do we see this? This shouldn't be there. Here is everything okay. Is it about it? Don't think so. Let's try it now. Hey, come on, you should have it. Yeah, this was too bright. You see now it's away. It was too bright for the floor. Okay, but we can do this even brighter for the cup. We can put here a fill light on. Let's make it fast render. Low GI here. And make it here. And let's see what the fill light does. So, whoops. Definitely works. Nice. But okay. And now let's see how this looks in a good render, a nicer render. So sometimes there are some situations you see this. Normally you don't see it. But sometimes there is a situation. Ah, come on. Hi, GI. So. Whoops. Yep. But you see, it renders very fast. It's the only thing what needs here a little bit is to send the HDRI to the Team Render machine. Yep, now we have it. We have a very nice cup of thing here. So this is this. Of course, now you can play with the magnet tool again and bring this far out and however you want it. But you see the way is good so. And if you say this is too less shadow for me, as I said, you can go, if you have the rig, you can go with the ambient occlusion of the floor ambient occlusion. If you don't have the rig, you can go to your material floor material, and you can set in the diffusion, you can set here the effects and ambient occlusion. And this works then just for the floor. So, and yeah. Let's one try again for this a little more of ambient occlusion. You can so ambient occlusion on, or just with not more, just with ambient occlusion. See if it makes a big difference. And how is it here? It's a little grainy, so but you can go with the samples a little up here. But we could do this in post work too. But because it renders quite fast, we can do it here too. So let's see if we see a difference with the ambient occlusion. If not, we have to go up with the contrast, that's all. So let's see. Yeah, of course you see it. And I think this is okay so. And now I make another render to avoid this thing. So I can show you what you have to set here. I see, okay, here the ambient occlusion is a little grainy too. So I have here in the physical settings, I have here an ambient occlusion subdivision mark, so I go up here to 4. And for this grainy thing here, you can go with the shading subdivision to the minimum up to 3. And we can, because this is a blurry material, we can go with the blurriness subdivisions up to 4, and now we should get a quite nice shadow. We don't have really shadows, we have just but let's go with the shadow up to this. Shouldn't make so much difference in the render time because we rendered only on 720p, so this shouldn't make much difference. Maybe the double, maybe 1 minute or something else, but the result should be better. You see it here and here. This is and as I said, we can if we don't want this, but I like this little grainy look here in the gold. And so now, yeah, I don't know if you see it in the record, but now here we have grainy ambient occlusion, and here if we go, it's away. Okay, and now let's take this thing and let's go a little to Photoshop with this. Oops, Shift F6. I copied this. Go to Photoshop, new, 16 bit from the clipboard, create, Control V, and we have it here. Make a smart object out of it, and with Control Shift A, we go to the camera raw filter. And here with the clarity, we don't play it this time because this wouldn't looks not so bad, but maybe a little clarity and. Then exposure a little up and the shadows a little up. The blacks and then the, but I don't think we need the clarity here. More contrast. Exposure no. Oops. No. There. Is nice so far. Yeah, I like it. There is nothing much to do here. The only thing, if you don't want this, I show you how you get. I showed it often, but I show it again. So, but first, let's see if we want maybe a little vignette here. Well, yeah, why not? Okay, and now again I make a smart object out of it, and again I take Control Shift A for the camera, and I go here to the luminance noise reduction, and then we should see then that this disappears here. You see, now it's totally smooth, and this would be okay. I do this. I could have done this with the noise reduction before too, but I was not sure if I wanted on the whole picture this noise reduction or just here on the thing. If you want it just on this place here, so you go to the smart filter here and activate it, and with Control I, you disable more than less the filter here, and you see the grain. And if you just want to remove the grain here, take a white pencil and a white brush now, and go with white, of course, as I said, go over these parts where you don't want the grain. So you see, so you get it just the filter just where you want it. So you see it here. We have now the filter here. So okay, this is I didn't want. So this would be the part where the filter is active. With Alt click on the mask, you get the mask. Yeah, but it's I think it's okay on the whole picture. So I make this whole thing white. So and I took. So now it is on the whole picture because I like this softness here too. Okay, this is our picture. And this was our tutorial. It was a quite quick tutorial, 40 minutes. I hope you liked it, and I hope you show me your results when you do this. I have my Facebook group for just showing results of the tutorials. It would be nice when to see it here. And yeah, you find every link in the description, every link you need. I put the link inside from this Behance here, from this Behance account too. So you can have a look here, and then you will find a link to my Facebook, to Nicomedia Scene Rig, to everything, to a donation if you want to support me. I really appreciate it. So donation link is there if you want to support me on Patreon. Patreon link is there. Yeah. And the next tutorial will, to 99% will come tomorrow. Maybe I do today one, but I don't think so. I have so much to do. But I have many tutorials on my list I have to do, but at the moment it's every time when I think, oh, okay, now it's getting quiet and more quiet, there comes something new. Don't misunderstand me. I love it. If I get jobs, no question about it. And I'm every time happy when I get something. But I work still alone, so it's a little, yeah, the day has just too few hours for me. This is a big problem. And sometimes in between I have to have a little session with my musician friends and so, yeah, and so on. Okay, I hope you like this. I like the result. I really like it. It's nice. And I hope to see you in the next tutorial, and I wish you a great day and a wonderful weekend. So all the best from Vienna, and tschüss und baba.